Hello friends, you welcome in my YouTube channel. Today I have brought a very important topic, continuity of a function. You know, if we have a function y is equal to fx, then it means it has a curve. Now when we are having a curve, then there arising two possibly situation. Suppose we have two situations. In first situation we have a curve like this, and in this situation suppose we have a curve like this. So for this curve we have drawn this curve in one stroke. It means without lifting the pen we are able to draw this curve. But whenever we are drawing this curve, we need to lift the pen. So it cannot be drawn in one single stroke. So it means this function is not continuous and this function is continuous. So this is the, you can say, a simple definition of a continuity. So suppose this point is called x is equal to a, this is called x is equal to a, then we can say that this function is not continuous at x is equal to a. But what is the method to find out the continuity of a function? So let's see. So check, suppose we have a curve and we have to check continuity of this function at x is equal to a. So draw an ordinate. How will we check that whether x function is continuous at x equal to a or not? So we need to check value of the function in the left neighborhood, then the value of the function in the right neighborhood, and the value of the function at sharp a, and all these three values must be equal. So that means we have to check the value of the function in the left neighborhood. So how will we write? We will write it like this: limit x tending to a negative of the function. What does it mean? That we are finding the value of this function in the left of a. A minus means left of a. And why we are putting limit? Limit means that we are finding the value of the function in the left neighborhood, and it is very close to a. It is not far away from a. It is very close, approachable to a. So this is why we are writing limit. So understand the meaning of this whole expression, that we are finding the value of the function fx in the left of a, and limit is saying that we are finding the value of the function very close to a. So this is called left hand limit. Now the value of the function in the right, so we will write it like this: limit x tending to a positive fx. So what does it mean? Now we are finding the value of fx, this we are finding the value of fx in the right neighborhood of a. And why we are putting limit? That we are finding the value of the function very close to a. It is not far away from a. So that we are putting limit, and this is called right hand limit. Now the third point is this: the value of the function at sharp a. So it means if we have a value left hand to a, then right hand to a, and at a, if all these values are same, then we will say the function is continuous. And remember, we can merge these two at a single limit, because in limit chapter you might have studied that If left hand limit and right hand limit are existing, then we can say the limit of the function at that particular point exists. And how can we write limit x tending to a? In both expression can be written as limit x tending to a fx is equal to fa. So we can define the limit of a function like this. How? That a function is said to be continuous at x equal to a if and only if that if limit x tending to a fx is equal to fa. This is the definition of a limit. So in simple language you should understand that if a function, we are checking the continuity of the function at a, so first of all we have to check a left neighborhood, then we have to check the right neighborhood and particularly a. These three values, left hand limit, right hand limit and a, these three values should be same. If these values are same, then we can say the function is continuous. It means we can draw such function in one single stroke. So now let's try some questions. Now we will discuss the continuity of modulus function. So what is modulus function? If you want to know what is modulus function, so watch my video modulus function. So here I have written this function. This function is r to r and this is the function. That the modulus value, that the value of the function is positive when x is positive and negative when x is negative and 0 when x is equal to 0. So here we have a curve of modulus function. So we have to check, we will not check the continuity of the function when the function is going on. Actually the problem is at 0, you see the problem is at 0, because at 0 the function is shifting its value. So we need to check the continuity of the function at x is equal to 0. Here we will check the continuity. This is the point where we will check the continuity of this function. So we can also write that continuity at x is equal to 0. This is how we can write. So to check it, first we will find left hand limit. So write left hand limit. So how it is written? That we are finding the value of the function at negative of 0. It means we are finding the value of the function very close and left to 0. Very close and left to 0. So how can we write this function? That we are finding the value, we are finding the value at left to the 0. This is called 0 minus h. It means a little left from the h. So the value of the function at 0 minus h, where h is very very small. H is very very small. So how can we write limit h tending to 0 f minus h? Now we have to check the value of the function at minus h, and you know minus h is negative, and whenever you have a negative value, so the value is minus x, or you can directly put into it also, like f minus h will be limit h tending to 0 f minus h will be mod of minus h, and limit h tending to 0 h, and if you are putting h is equal to 0, so 0. So your left hand limit is 0. Now we will find right hand limit. So how will we find right hand limit? See this expression. Now we will write it for the right hand limit 0 positive of fx. Now we are going a little ahead from the 0, little more than 0. It means we are finding this limit 0 plus h, but h should be very small. So limit h tending to 0, 0 plus h means fh. So because fx is modulus x, so fh is modulus h. So limit h tending to 0 modulus h, and whose value will be h, and you can put h 0, so you have a 0. Now, what is the value of the function at a? It means 0. So, f0. So, f0 is already given 0. It is already given 0. So, now see, left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to the value of the function at 0. All three values are same. So, you can say that a function fx is continuous at x is equal to 0. So, we had a doubt whether the function is continuous or not at x is equal to 0, because at rest of the value function is already continuous. Now, at 0 we have checked the function is continuous. It means the modulus function is continuous everywhere. Remember, modulus function is continuous everywhere. So, now we will do some more questions and we will check their continuity. Now, we will study continuity of signum function. So, to understand signum function, watch my video about signum function. So, here, this is signum function. So, fx is defined as, for non-zero values of x, we will find x, fx, with this formula, and for x is equal to 0, the value of the function will be 0. And this is the curve of the signum function. Right? So now, where will we check the continuity of signum function? At 0. Because 0 is the value where function is shifting. Or you can say, we have a doubt at x is equal to 0. Because ahead from the 0, the function will start continuous and you can draw it. Then beyond 0, function is also continuous, you can draw it continuously. But at 0, we have a doubt. So we will clear our doubt whether the function is continuous at x is equal to 0 or not. So for that, you know, we will have to find left hand limit, right hand limit and the value of the function at x equal to 0, and we shall check it. So come and check left hand limit first. So I have to write first of all that here I am finding the continuity of the function. So continuity at x is equal to 0. So we will write left hand limit. So left hand limit will be written as that limit x tending to 0 negative of fx. It means we are finding the value of the function left to the 0. Okay? And this is also written as x tending to 0 f0 minus h. That is limit x tending to 0 f minus h. Now we have to find the value of the function at minus h, and obviously h is tending to 0 but not equal to 0. So see, we have to find the value of this function from this formula because we are finding at non-zero value. So fx is equal to modulus x upon x. So use this formula, write your function limit x tending to 0. So will be mod of minus x upon minus h. And see this rule. We are finding from this rule. So now limit x tending to 0. So modulus of minus x will be x, and this is minus x, and we can cancel it because it's not 0, it is tending to 0. So limit x tending to 0 we have minus 1, and obviously it is a constant, so no matter where is limit is tending to, so we have minus 1. So this way we have found left hand limit. Now we will find right hand limit. So see, how will we write right hand limit? Limit x tending to 0 positive of fx. This means limit x tending to 0 f 0 plus h. This means limit x tending to 0 and the value of the function at h. Limit x tending to 0. Now we have to find the value of the function at h, and obviously h is not 0. It is tending to 0 but not 0. So here from we can find the value. So now modulus h upon h. So limit h tending to 0. So modulus h is h, and upon h. So finally we have 1, and limit h tending to 0, 1 will be 1. Now what is the value of the function at 0? This is already given 0. Now you see, left hand limit is minus 1. Right hand limit is 1. and the value of the function at 0 is 0. All three are different. It means left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit is not equal to 0. Sometimes these two are equal. All three must be equal. So here in this case, no one is equal to anyone. So it means the function fx is not continuous at x is equal to 0. So remember, signum function is not continuous at x is equal to 0. And obviously, you see the graph. If I cannot draw this graph with single stroke. Whenever I am drawing this graph, I have to lift the pen. It cannot be drawn in single stroke. And it is proved analytically also that this function is not continuous at x equal to 0. Now we will see some more examples. So stay watching. Now see this question. Discuss the continuity of f. We have to discuss the continuity of this function and see this function. The value of this function is x plus 2. But when x is smaller than 1 or equal to 1. But whenever x is greater than 1, the value of the function will be given to this output. So this is our function. Now you know that before 1, x is a polynomial and polynomial function is continuous everywhere. Similarly, after 1 it is again a continuous. It is a linear polynomial, so it will be continuous everywhere. Where we need to check the continuity of the function? We will check the continuity of the function at 1 only. This is the point where we have a doubt. So let's check. So first writing down continuity at x is equal to 1. We will write like this. So we are finding continuity at 1. So you know left hand limit you have to find. And how will you write? Limit x tending to 1 negative of fx. It means you are finding the value of the function before 1 negative and very close to 1. Then limit h tending to 0 1 minus f. Remember, these two statements are having same meaning. So in this statement we are finding the value of the function at 1 minus h, which means we are finding the value 1 minus h before 1, and h is very small. It means we are closing to 1. So limit h tending to 0. So we have to find the value of the function at 1 minus h, and 1 minus h is less than 1. So we have to move here. So what will be the value of the function? See, f x equal to x plus 2. So f 1 minus h will be 1 minus h plus 2. So if you put h tending to 0, so this term will become 0 and 1 plus 2, 3. So we have left hand limit 3. Now we will find right hand limit, and how will we write? Limit x tending to 1 positive of fx. It means limit h tending to 0 at f 1 plus h. So now we are finding the value of the function 1 plus h at this range. It is greater than 1. 1 plus h is greater than 1. So here from. So limit h tending to 0. So 1 plus h means 1 plus h minus 2. So we will find the value of the function with this value. So now if you put h tending to 0, so you will get 1 minus 2 minus 2. So no need to find the value of the function at 1, because these two are not equal. So what is the benefit to find the value at 1? So you can write, because since left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, so we need not to check further. So fx is not continuous at x is equal to 1. So it is not continuous at 1, and elsewhere it is continuous. Beyond ahead from 1 or beyond from 1, it is continuous, but especially at x equal to 1 it is not continuous. So now see more example. Keep watching. Now see this question. It is little twisted question. You need not to check continuity of this function. Continuity is given in this function.
Just read out the question.
Find the relationship between A and B. Because there are two unknown variables, two unknown constants, A and B. So we have to find the relationship. It means we have to find an equation connecting A and B. Okay? So that the given function is continuous at x is equal to 3. It is given that the function is continuous at x equal to 3. So if the function is continuous, so left hand limit, right hand limit, and the value of the function, all three must be same. So first of all, we will find these values separately and we will put them equal, then we will find the relationship. This is the strategy of this question. So first we go for the left hand limit. So for left hand limit, because we are finding limit at 3, so we will write like this: limit x tending to 3 negative of the function. This means limit f 3 minus h, where h is very small, and the value of the function at 3 minus h less than 3. See, less than 3. So we will find the function value like this. So in place of x, we will put 3 minus h. So we will have a into 3 minus h and plus 1, and your h is tending to 0. Now you will put x is equal to 0. So you have 3a plus 1. This is your left hand limit. So now we will find right hand limit. So you will have to write limit x tending to 3 positive fx. It means the value of the function is more than 3, but not far away, very close, h is very small. So 3 plus h, because greater than 3. So we will find the value of the function with this rule. So in place of x, you will put 3 plus h. So b into 3 plus h and plus 3, limit h is tending to 0. Now put h is tending to 0, so you will have 3b and plus 3. This is your right hand limit. Now you will find the value of the function at particularly 3. So where from you will get the value? See, equal to 3. It is also hold for equal to 3. So again we will find with this. So f3 will be 3a plus 1. 3a plus 1. So left hand limit, right hand limit, and we have the value of the function. Since fx is continuous at x is equal to 3, so we must have left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to the value of the function at 3. So what is your left hand limit? 3a plus 1. What is your right hand limit? 3b plus 3. And what is the value of the function at 3? 3a plus 1. So all these three must be equal, because first and third term are the same, so we can take these two only. So 3a plus 1 is equal to 3b plus 3. So bring 3b here. 3a minus 3b is equal to 3, 1. 3 minus 1, 2. And we can take a 3 common, so it can be written as 2 by 3. So this is the required relation between a and b. So we will do more question. Keep watching. Now see this question. It is very important question for CBSE, ISC. It is very important question. So just see, for what value of k, we have to find the value of k. And this function fx is equal to k cos x pi minus 2x 3. So this function is continuous at pi by 2. Like previous question, we are not checking continuity. It is already given that the function is continuous at pi by 2. We have to find k, because k is unknown. So you know the process of continuity. First of all, we have to find left hand limit. So we are checking continuity at pi by 2. So left hand limit, remember our x is pi by 2. So how will we write left hand limit? Limit x tending to pi by 2 negative of the function. So left to pi by 2. So next step is limit of, we are finding the value of the function then at pi by 2 minus h, because left to pi by 2 is pi by 2 minus h. You can understand this is our pi by 2, and left to it pi by 2 minus h, and right to it pi by 2 plus h. Okay, but h is very small. This is limit value. So now we have to find the value of the function at this. So because it is not pi by 2, so we can apply this formula to find the function. So fx is equal to this, and we have to find pi by 2 minus h. So how can we write k cos, in place of x write pi by 2 minus h, then pi minus 2, and in place of x pi by 2 minus h, and remember h is tending to 0. Now next step, limit h is tending to 0, k cos 90 minus theta, obviously sin theta, so we write sin h, pi will multiply, so 2 minus pi, and it is minus minus plus 2h, so cancel pi with pi. So we have, see here, so we have limit h is tending to 0 in numerator k sin h, and in denominator we are left with 2h. So you know we can rearrange it like this, that k by 2 is one factor and sin h upon h is another factor. Why? Because this is a standard limit. Limit h tending to 0, sin h upon h is 1. Remember it. I am writing down here. It is a standard limit that if limit is h tending to 0, then sin h upon h will be 1. This is standard limit. So when we apply limit, so here we have 1. So k by 2 into 1, it is k by 2. It is our left hand limit. Now we will find right hand limit. So right hand limit will be, how can we write? Limit x tending to pi by 2 positive of the function, which will equal to limit x tending to 0 and the value of the function at pi by 2 plus h. Again we are finding the value of the function at pi by 2 plus h, which is not equal to pi by 2, so we will find with the same value. We'll apply this. So limit h is tending to 0. So k cos in place of x, we will have pi by 2 plus h upon pi minus 2 pi by 2 plus h. So keep simplifying. K cos 90 plus h, this time minus sin h. Minus sin h upon pi minus pi and minus 2h. So cancel minus with minus. So we have limit h tending to 0 k by 2 into sin h upon h, which is again, if you are putting h tending to 0, this will become 1, and we have k by 2. So same. Now we will find the value of the function at pi by 2. So at pi by 2, the value of the function is 3. So because it is given that the function is continuous, we are not checking continuity, it is already given. The function is continuous at pi by 2. So we must have left hand limit is equal to right hand limit and the value of the function at pi by 2. So what is your left hand limit? K by 2. And what is the right hand limit? K by 2. And what is the value? 3. So put these two equal, that is, this implies k by 2 is equal to 3, and this implies k is equal to 6. Yeah, here we have got, here we have answer that k is equal to 6. It is very important question. So one last question, keep watching. Now see this question. We have to find the value of a and b, and the function is given continuous. So again, you are not checking continuity of the function. Continuity is given. That is, the function is continuous at 2 and 10. So we will take these two cases separately. Continuity at x is equal to 2 and continuity at x is equal to 10. So first we are taking continuity at x is equal to 2. So we will find left hand limit to negative of the function, which will be 5. Similarly, we will find right hand limit at 2. So because 2 plus h is greater than 2, so this value will be given. So this is your right hand limit. And now the value of the function at 2 which is already 5. So because it is continuous, so these three must be equal. Left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to value. So 2a plus b is equal to 5. So first relation, we have found first relation with the help of this continuity. Similarly, it is also continuous at x is equal to 10. So we will find left hand limit beyond 10, before 10, which is 10a plus b. And after 10, we have 21. And at 10, we have 21. So for continuity, these three must be equal. So this way we have got another equation, second. Now we will solve these two questions, first and second, and simultaneously, and we will get a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 1. So keep watching my videos. Thank you very much.